All right, we're gonna try something different today. I've got a blower and I need a bottom end, because if you didn't watch that video, 7 pistons on a small block Chevy is not quite enough. So what better thing to do than the completely wrong thing? Take a small block Chevy, stock application, stock form, you don't even know if it runs, put that blower on top of it. Well, I don't know if it runs right now. Let's see if we can get it running. I got this, I'm guessing early, mid 80s, van, 3/4 ton, 8-lug wheels, stabbing cabin, home storage van down by the river.
And I live in a van down by the river.
This thing, a buddy of mine that scraps, dropped it off, I don't know, a year ago. He said, hey, I'm gonna scrap this thing. I said, hey, that thing should have a turbo 400 in it. And I might need a turbo 400 to hold all the horse torques of the blower. Wait, there's already a turbo 400 behind that. But there might be another project coming down the pipeline that needs a turbo 400. Anyway, this thing's quadrajet, small block, automatic, HEI, side post, battery terminals, pretty much all the stuff that says quickest wheeler run in the world. This thing's been off the road since 2003. Doesn't seem like that long ago, but that was 21 years ago. So let's just drag this thing in and see if we can set a new world record for the quickest will it run. We're not going to do a walk around. It's going to probably take us longer to get this thing in the shop than it is to get it running. Partly because you are no help and that thing's in the way so that I can get this thing out of here. All right, I'm going to get this thing outside. We're just going to scoot this thing right in. Boot scoot boogie.
I guess Duff's going to lead the way.
Chevy truck right behind it. Somebody should buy this thing so it can be their yard art and not mine. Oh, come on. Gotta put the ball on the forks.
Gotta get some pictures for the Instagram.
Not warm out there. Crank the heat up. Ugh. Not die, getting out of that thing. And let it thaw out a bit while we grab some tools, side post battery, probably a loser switch. I did check, keys are in it. Well, because we had to shift her out of the gear. But yeah, I think he gave me, I don't know what I paid for this thing. 300 bucks, we'll say. But he's like, hey, I want 400 bucks, but if I can keep the grill, I'll give it to you for 300 bucks. I was like, perfect. You can have the grill and headlight bezels. Ooh, it does have push bumpers. It's a Beauville special, whatever that is. It's not the Beau James option. What are you doing, you window licker? We present to you this week's Mortske Minute, brought to you live by mortske.com. Go check them out for all your super amazing merch. This week's Mortske Minute is shot live from our Checker Aerobus. Yeah. They're cool, and they're probably not really echoey inside. You guessed it, this week's Mortske Minute is about the Beauville. Beauville? I think it's Beauville. Anyway, the Beauville started as an option in 1954 on Chevrolet 210 station wagons. Pretty much how you out that option was a little bit of wood grain trim around the windows. Got the stock engine, stock trim that came on your 210. Slight step up over the 150. Carried into 1955. In 1956, though, it was available on the Bel Air station wagons as well. High rollers. Kept it around for one more year, 1957. Dropped it down. Only available on the 210s once again. And then it would disappear to never be seen until the van. In 1970, Chevrolet Motor Division, whatever we're calling it,
Chevy van brought back the Beauville one more time as the highest trim package available for their vans, slightly above the, you guessed it, the sports van. If you were a GMC fanatic, you could have got the Rally STX, which was their equivalent of the Beauville, which was slightly above the Rally van. Did I say 1970s? Actually, 1971 carried through 1976. It was the highest option, as I said, over the sport van, which got you higher trim package and nicer seats. Yeah, those seats were real nice. Way nicer than the Checker Aerobus bus seats that I'm sitting on right now. Seat, singular. And that's about it for the old Beauville, but one more tidbit. I'd never heard of this one before. The Bonaventure. It's so much fun to say. It was actually a trim package that came in between the sport van and the Beauville, which was, you guessed it, a combination of sport van trim and Beauville trim. So there you have it. This week's Mortske Minute, brought to you by Mortske.com and Checker Motors. Are Checker Motors still in business? Stay tuned to find out. Now back to your regularly scheduled shenanigans. Chrome bumpers, I think you could get them with painted. It's got windows, so they upgraded for that. Must have AC. It's got a couple hubcaps, chrome mirrors. Oh, tilt, cruise. We gotta fix that window so we can store stuff in it. She's pretty soggy. Fake dual exhaust, I presume. Chrome rear bumper. I don't think they're the, I know they're not the same as pickups, but guys make them work. But she's got a pretty big hooey in it. Sold new at Resler's. Comes with all kinds of goodies. But we're not gonna show you all the goodies because we're gonna do a speed will it run. Looks like a cooler toolbox with no sockets in it. Spray pump. Some type of, I don't know, a body. We gotta get the seats out so we can store, you know, small block Chevy heads and blocks and whatnot in it. Right, Duff? Oh, got two windows to fix. A little snowy in there. She had all the seats. How many passengers is this thing? Like 2, 5, 8, I don't know, 11 passenger? Big dog in it. All right, furnaces are gonna fire up here, so it's gonna get loud. See you in a little bit. All right, here we go. It is 2:17 in the afternoon. This thing's thawed out. Let's get after it. First thing we're gonna do is open the hood. This is an inside pop, so Duff is no help. Hood prop rod? Got it. It's too short. And the beauty of vans are, you can't see anything except for this giant, oh my gosh, that is a new world record. I don't know if that's a bird, mouse, rat, I don't know what's in there. Let's just dispose of that properly. Before we get started, we should check the dipstick, Jimmy, because that's what we're trying to save is the engine. World's largest dipstick, let me get 14 feet away. And it's barely on the stick. Perfect. Go back in there. Coolant, probably better check that just in case it does run for a while. There isn't even room to get your freaking hands on it. We're just gonna assume it's got coolant in it. Battery, over here. Side post. Battery sponsor this week, Mr. Meeseeks.
I'm Mr. Meeseeks, look at me!
Two, he was so gracious, he sponsored us a second time. You too can be a battery sponsor at mortski.com. Where is the ground at? Found it. They're barely even stripped off. Oh, what's this cable for? Speedo? Remind me if that doesn't work later, that's why it doesn't work. How in the French does this go? Snug as a bug on drugs. Come on. All right, guess we'll be hooking the ground up first because can't get at it otherwise. Then we're gonna do it the right way with the pliers. Should be good. Keys off, I checked. I also put it in park. So we don't run ourselves over when this thing comes roaring right to life.
Now let's lift it up in the air and cut the fuel line so we don't suck up any. I don't know, who's that 2003? Bush administration? Nah, that was probably Obama. Anyway, let's lift it up in the air and cut the fuel line. 3 minutes in. I may have cheated and set the lift up already.
Son of a biscuit, it does have legit duals on it. And no catalytic converters? This thing's a hot rod.
Sway bar, power steering, smog pump. We're just gonna forget about that. So here's our fuel pump. Looks like it's got that terrible tiny little return line. So we're gonna cap that off and we're gonna cut this one off and we're gonna hook our boat tank up to it. Or we're just gonna hook a hose up to it for now until we get it set on the ground. Easy peasy, a lemon squeezy. I guess we should have looked to see if that was a 305 or a 350. I doubt it's a 400 because this thing's newer than that, but we can get the doghouse out on the inside and look. That might be locked up. They like to do that. Also, these are unibody. Crossmember bolts to it. They don't have legit frame rails. Here, we're listening to information of the day. Enough rambling. More working. Looks like somebody's replaced this thing at one time. Imagine that. I guess it was only on the road for 20-ish years. We should just try starting it on gas. It's 20 years old sometime. Not today though. All right, I think we'll cut this off. Slide a bolt in there. We don't need no stinking return line. Ooh. Doesn't smell that bad. So that's a plus. Just kidding, it now reeks. And it's not 7/16. That costed us some time. Get her in there good and tight. Nice new chunk of 3/8 fuel hose. Coming right up. All right, send her back out on the ground. 225, 8 minutes in. Hook up a boat tank and an electric pump just in case. Don't forget to put the hose clamp on. There we go. Got our cute little 12-volt adapter. Let's prime the system. Wait for it to get quiet. That's when you know it's doing its thing. I think we're golden. We're gonna unhook it for safety. Now, let's hit the key. 10 minutes in, exactly. 227. Right there. Oh, I gotta go grab another camera. Just in case some mouse house comes out of the tailpipe to record it. That's gonna cost us some time. Better yet, I'm just gonna use this camera.
Slingshot engaged.
Slingshot engaged.
The dog says, check the doghouse. Dump some gas in the quadrajet. Fine. That just cost us another minute. 228. Ugh. Speaking of dog, is that a dog cone? That is. You want to put on a dog cone, Duff? Folding chair, folding table, legs, times two. Ooh, a coffee pot. A tarp strap, Kilo. There's all kinds of good stuff. Funnels. It's a Coleman even. What's in it? Probably don't want to know. No kidneys. All right. What do we got? This one just got, where's the latches? It's got hardware. Dang it, this is just gonna pop right off. Blech. 13 millimeter. Good thing the half inch was already on the impact. Oh no. Engine oil stop leak, which is convenient because it is leaking. We should probably not put that back in here. Cap filters, windshield scraper, rear view mirror. Ooh. Giant wrench.
Squirrel!
Okay. At a glance, I see it's got an AM/FM cassette, so that's a plus. Probably.
Why?
Well, that's got the latch. Thought they were Phillips screws. Twizzlers? I haven't had those in forever. Cheese and rice. There it is. Just had to put some hair on it. Flip the latch over here. All right.
That was a nice
glue job. How come these never fit? Coming out.
Burning time.
All right, HEI. Why is it not running?
Let's just pull the air cleaner off and drizzle some gas in there. Maybe we're not getting gas. Maybe it's plugged up with the filter. Maybe the float is stuck. Eland seat. I'm breathing hard. It's not because I'm working hard. It's because I'm fat. Just kidding, it wasn't a cassette, just AM, FM. She's a smogger. Got all the orifice tubes coming out of the manifolds, but it doesn't have headers, so that's a plus. I think they made these things with TBIs. This has gotta be a carburetor. Why? Just freaking come out of there. What are you hooked on? All of the smog. So many vacuum lines. That's why I was spinning hard, since it's got that silly bent rod for the air cleaner. One more on hook. Two more. Got them all. Oh, never mind. 74 vacuum lines. Alright. Quadrabog. Is it free? Yep. Alright, let's get the gasolina. Give her a tickle, a little hot sauce. Right down the gumption. Okay. I'm gonna drizzle some gas in there and run that electric pump and play whack-a-mole on the front of that thing to see if it'll unstick it. Good thing I got the mole whacker. Where does the line come in at? Same spot it comes in on all the quarter bugs, dummy. The front. Passenger side. Ooh, this is the one with all the torque screws in it. It's a late one. All right, I'm gonna go turn the pump on.
234 Duff, 17 minutes in. It's taking too long, I know. You wanna go for an RIDE.
In case you were not aware, at 19 minutes in, we're having some technical difficulties with the old quadrabog. If I dump gas down it, it runs great. But if I don't dump gas down it, it just doesn't run at all. I'm even trying to bottle feed it by just letting the old hot sauce bottle drip down into the bowl, and it still don't want to keep running.
Maybe we fixed it.
See? I guess I'm gonna pull that fuel line off up there, see if we're getting gas up there from the pump, but I don't know why it wouldn't. Got any ideas, Duff? All right. Maybe that's why they parked it. Let's take the fuel line off the carburetor. And the joys of YouTube, let's swap a battery out. According to this thing, we're 20 minutes and 31 seconds. Sure enough, 237. So let's put a battery in this thing, grab some line wrenches, and see if we're getting fuel up top. Also, let's make sure we don't have a giant puddle on the floor from fuel. No leaks. So our plug must be working. I guess our pump could maybe not be pumping, but it should. All right. Let's pull a fuel line off.
Well, drain our whole hot sauce bottle out. That wasn't what I wanted to do. That's gonna cost us some time refilling that. Turn the key off. I could move the camera so you guys could get a better angle.
There, can you see now? This fuel line has yet to be twisted in a circle. So let's see if we can keep that streak going. Sure enough, the filter wants to spin. And there's no good way to get at it. Can't see it from the front side. Anybody got a stubby 1-inch wrench? You know what I'm gonna get? A locking pliers.
This has got the filter housing that's got the extension on it that's round instead of being hex the whole way. So I'm just gonna grab onto that round part of the fuel filter housing. Since I can't get on the hex. And really, if I clamp this in the right spot, it won't be able to turn anyways. Brilliant. I am the smartest man. Oh man, we got all kinds of pressure there. So, why is it not getting fuel into the carburetor? Fuel filters usually never plug far enough where they don't get fuel enough to idle. Shut up, buzzer. Usually needle and seats stick open, so they just flow fuel everywhere. Choke off, maybe? I think we're gonna have to take apart a quadrajet, kid. Or we just turn the choke off. I mean, it's not running great, but it's running. So if the choke's off, that means it's getting too much fuel and you can't look down in there because it's a van. 243, so we're 26 minutes in here. This is where I would usually take apart a quadrajet, clean it all up, but that's not gonna be very efficient. I could bolt another one on, but that's gonna take some time. I could adapt an Edelbrock, but that would take me more time. What are we gonna do? What is your problem? Quadrajet's just usually quadrajet. Do you wanna beat him? Ooh, it's the one with the electric choke, so that's a plus. I think our most efficient way would be to swap a different one on there. I'm gonna go look and see what we got, but I don't know that we got one laying loose and ready to go. And if I go steal one off another vehicle, that's gonna take even more time. Well, that was a 22 minute debacle. 309. That bent fuel line did not want to bend back into place. We don't have our throttle linkage hooked up, but let's see if our derby car carburetor is gonna work. Let's hook up the return spring though, just so we don't get stuck going WFO. See how many vacuum leaks we got, because I just kind of ripped everything off. Just like that. All right, now I need to figure out something for our throttle. We're not gonna hook up the cruise control, unfortunately. Fortunately, I don't know. I'll be back in a second. Two shakes of the jackrabbits. Oh, let me show you what we got going on here. Oh, that was glass, it sounded like. So we gotta put this tab like this on the carburetor, because mine doesn't have it. And this is crimped on, so we can't take this one off and reuse it. I'm gonna do some digging. All right, we got this little stud with a cotter key. Hopefully that is the right diameter. Don't drop the screws down the carburetor. Oh, that diameter will work. I could have saved myself a bunch of time by putting all this on the carburetor when it was sitting on the bench, because it's real fun to do it leaning over a steering wheel, but it could be worse. Oh no. Time to get a magnet. Get your magnetic screwdriver at mortske.com. It'll work well under pressure. Get all shaky. Definitely gonna have a sandwich after this. Of course, JM Construction had to show up in the middle of this, and since I'm on the clock, literally, I couldn't pause it, and I couldn't just kick him out because he's gonna pour some concrete for me. So, that didn't help. Throttle linkage hooked up. Let's test it out. Looks good. Let's dump a quart of oil in. Check the transmission. How do the brakes feel? Ooh, real good. Let's just check the tranny now. Well, let's put a quart of oil in and then give her the old back and forth test. What do you think, Duff? 317. What's that, hour in? Dang, we're ready for a test drive almost. So we're gonna have to find a home for that thing. That seems about right. Plug that back up. Let's check to make sure the feel like brakes have no fluid. Fluid. We'll put a little in that reservoir. Even though I'm guessing that's for the rears. Don't fill that up, because it is leaky. You know how I know? Because it says. This thing holds like 2 teaspoons. No wonder it's empty. I wonder what this has got. You know, 60? Probably a corporate. All right, I'm gonna fire it up. Maybe it'll stay running. Maybe we'll just give her the old forward reverse test to see if the tranny's working. And then we can go for an RIDE. Does that work for YOU? Oh, almost lost our screwdriver. Hour and 3 minutes in. Transmission, but we got some wheel dragging. Oh, I bet when I hit the brakes, I locked up the calipers up front. Let's lift it up in the air and see that the calipers are dragging. Dang it. I guess I never tried to push it to see if it rolled, but I drug it with the skid steer. All the wheels appeared to be turning. Well, like I said, that was before I hit the brakes. Let's turn that clickety-clack off. We don't need you right now. Sure enough, locked up both sides. Oh, great. Since we don't really know if these turned by hand before, we don't really have a baseline. But they don't turn now. Let's crack the bleeders and see if they turn. That'll tell us if it's maybe the brake hose. I bet the 3/8 wrench is still inside the cab. Dang it. And it's gonna be 3/8. 10 millimeter metric. What a terrible time for automobiles. Half metric, half standard. Oh, nice. Tight. Oh, well, we got a little fluid come out there. So I think it's the brake hose. We can get enough pressure to go through to apply the brakes, but it doesn't put enough pressure on the caliper to push it back. So this will work just fine if we don't hit the brakes. They'll work fine once. This side, not so much. Well, what are we gonna do here? Can't really get a bar on that wheel. Let's just beat the crap out of the calipers. Can't hurt, right? Didn't help though. Fudge. Yep, she ain't turning. Well, I guess we'll free a stuck caliper. All right, just don't hit the brakes. Unless it's an emergency, of course. You know, like there's a
school bus full of nuns.
And puppies. And kindergartners. And we definitely don't need 8 lug nuts. 4 is good enough for the... Going down. Be long enough to reach in the seat. Hold that on the window. Sorry, Duff. You're sharing your seat with him. Oh yeah, Duff hates riding in vans. Something about an engine screaming in his face. Oh yeah, that definitely won't get in the tire. Oh, I thought I got free pliers. My own pliers back.
Well, let's just see if we can get this thing backed outside. 3:35, hour and 18 in. There you have it, folks, 3:38, 1 hour, 21 minutes. It's running a little rich, or it's burning some oil, or that's just a lot of humidification. Anyway, we gotta have the window down on the passenger side to run the fuel line out. Duff can't come with, because he doesn't like vans with the whole engine there, and I don't wanna put the engine cover back on, because we're gonna pull that engine out, and we got the fuel tank on his seat, so Duff's just gonna run around and be Duff. We don't really have much for brakes, so we're probably just gonna keep it in the yard, maybe. So, no Duff cam. I'm gonna grab a sweatshirt, because it's nipply out. And we're gonna throw a camera inside and go test on this thing, see if the tranny and engine are any good, and then maybe combine them with a blower. Comment down below if you wanna see us do more speed revivals. Although, I don't think my body and my obesity and my blood pressure can handle doing them. I can't imagine what it would be like on something hard like a Y block. Or a Cadillac.
Bullshit.
But yeah, hour 21. See, you too can have your own YouTube channel. For 1 hour and 21 minutes worth of work every week, you can get hundreds of thousands of views. And then there's the editing and the getting all the parts and having them on hand in the shop and maintaining it and getting the cars and finding the cars and paying for the cars and probably a bunch of other things that I'm forgetting. So go check out our merch, mortski.com. Get yourself a shirt, a cap, because there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes and it costs money. And clearly, as you can tell, we're really killing it around here. Yeah, someday. We haven't lost the shop, so we got that going for us. Got the Duff beer flag flying today, and some snowflakes, and an electric pump running wide open over there. Oh, here's the clamp for the window.
I wonder if the fuel pump works so we can turn off that noisy one. Never mind about noise, we got an engine scream right at our feet. You're fine.
Oh, somebody should have bypassed the neutral safety.
Thought it was drafty and my window's up, but it's coming in on that one. Don't hit the brakes. Probably use a tune-up. Oh, it's got some sweet dirt diggers on the back, too. Once you slide a corner. Oh, yeah! And there's the Duff. Now he's like, I'm gonna go for a ride. Oh, it gets it. This thing's
doesn't even need a blower on top of it. Well, we better test the tranny on it, since that's kind of what we're after. Oh, don't die on us now. That's unfortunate. What's banging? Uh-oh. Not where we want to be. We're just gonna dump her in the rhubarb. Maybe. And we're back in action. Determine if it hits third. Well, why is it cutting out? We got fuel in the tank. Why doesn't it crank over in neutral? Son of a. Oh, we're gonna take the rhubarb. Taking the rhubarb. Hopefully there's a nice approach down here to use. Yeah, she's an off-roading machine. Yeah, why doesn't it crank in neutral? This thing's junk. What's your problem? We didn't bring any tools with. We got our carburetor smacker. Surely my derby car carburetor's good. Well, it did a couple donuts. I'm gonna do the walk of shame back to the farm and grab a tow truck. A minute will probably just start back up when I get back. Did we rip our fuel line off? It's so cold! Fuel hose is hooked up. I wonder if we put the fuel tank on the roof. Ugh. Get some gravity action. That'll clearly tell bypassers that we know what we're doing. The pump quieted down. Is that all it was? Nope. It's like sleeting outside. Big bang. Got the fuel tank on the roof trying to get some gravity action going. The door and the fuel tank. Whoops! Should have kept that tarp strap. Oh, should have bought our Mortske repair beanie cap. It's so cold. Got a little mole by. There goes the fuel tank. How can we get some fuel action going and get the fuel tank up high enough for gravity feed? If only Duff was with to use his thumbs. Oh, we got the cooler. We'll set it on the kidney cooler. Is it a kidney or is it a liver? Oh, you could sell it. You got. Ah! Kidneys, you only got one livers.
Well, that bucket's to hold the seat ahead. Can't steal that bucket.
We should have had a fuel cam camera. Come on, baby. Must be a one-wheel peel, because as soon as we get one wheel off the ground, we lose traction. Just a fuel issue, no big deal. Loves it. Oh yeah, we got no brakes. Where's the approach at? Oh, it was right there. Where's the next one at? That's not a steep ditch. We'll back down that. Maybe. Still don't get why this thing doesn't crank in neutral. Tell you what, those super traction TA ultra grabbers are pretty good. This door latch isn't. Of course, the steering column's all flopped out in the tilt. Well, I think we fixed the fuel issue. Just got to get the tank up high enough so it's gravity feeding the electric pump and then the mechanical pump. Doesn't run too bad. My derby car carburetor needs a tune-up. And I think this engine in general just needs a tune-up. And we need a lot less traffic. That's what we need. Oh my gosh, it's like steady. And of course the speedometer isn't working. And everything else is idiot lights. Except the fuel tank, which says full. Here's our brake. Let's not die on the highway. Come on, baby. Oh, yeah. We're golden. I never really paid attention, but I think it's shifting through the gears. Definitely shifts down in first. Open the door, Duff. Trying to get the brakes going on the lift. Son of a biscuit. I need a sandwich to relax myself after that. That was nerve-wracking. Wrecking all of the nerves. Well, we made her. Nobody died. Look at these things. What are they? Power King Radial Traction LT 950 R16.5. Yeah, you can see we were getting after her a bit. She hooks her pretty good. Anyway, tranny seems to work good enough that it's worth swapping into something else. Engine got some blow by.
But if we're pulling the tranny, this thing's pretty much junk just for storing stuff in anyway. So we might as well pull the whole shooting match out of there. There's no good way to dig an engine out of a van that I have found so that it can never go back together again. So we're gonna get out the torch and the Sawzall and the pry bar and the side cutters and the crowbar and the big hammer. We're gonna make a mess of this thing. If you wanna see guys fix these things, go check out Dalton down at Pole Barn Garage. He put a big block in one and also made it four-wheel drive and shortened the wheelbase all at the same time. But he kind of sacrificed three vans to make one. We're just sacrificing one van to make a blower motor. Alrighty, sorry Beauville, you're getting the axe. No brakes, no title. Lots of rust, no windows. We're cutting her up. Let's hope it's a 350. I should probably check the casting numbers. I'm guessing it's a 710 block. It's not a 710 block, but it says 5.7 liter right there. So she's a 5.7. Good enough for the girls we go with. All right, let's get to ripping it out. I think the way that you rip these things out, I think you're supposed to take them out through the passenger door, maybe. I don't know. Out the bottom, who knows? We do it how we want. All right, you got the metric sockets out. Let's destroy it. I wouldn't say perfectly good van, but let's get the engine out of here. It should be real fun. Looks like these later ones got a core support that unbolts. Never had one of those before, so it should be a real treat. Great success. I've never done one of these where you pulled the transmission out first, and that made it easier, I think. The thing I was struggling with at the end was, guess what? Headers. Factory headers. Header. Singular. No! They're both headers. 86. Whew. Apparently had headers with the old smoggerisms. They got the big 2.5 inch exhaust, so I think, yeah, this is a one piece rear main seal. So this is kind of a neat one. So the one piece rear main seal, it's got that cast aluminum housing back there, but it's still got the regular perimeter valve cover bolts on it. So that's pretty neat.
How neat is that?
So the thing I like about that is you can put cool valve covers on it and you get the no leaks that comes with
the one piece rear main seal, because every two piece rear main seal I've ever done leaks, because that's just what they do. But that's a pretty good snag there. Didn't even use the old gas axe, but we I got sick of it at the end there, and I think you got to take these motor mounts off, maybe, I don't know. So I just kind of mowed through that bracket right there. You just weld that back in place. That's not structural, right? Fixed it. Didn't cut any of the wire harness, cut a whole bunch of AC and vacuum stuff. So yeah, we just unhooked the engine harness right there. And I left the cruise control harness with the vehicle because that's an add-on harness. These two wires, I think, was that reverse lights or neutral safety or something, was torn out of the transmission already. But yeah, pretty good. And I think if you took all the smog and AC and power steering and manifolds off, it would come out of there a lot easier. But ain't nobody got time for that.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
So now I think what I'm gonna do is take all that junk that I just mentioned off of there. And this does have, like, I don't know, a flat belt. It's not a serpentine belt, it's a flat belt, somebody said, or a groove belt, whatever. Our engine doesn't have that stuff. It's gonna be our blower setup, I think. It's anyway, we're gonna take all that off there. It's got this silly van power steering pump where it's got a cap that leads to this reservoir up here and whatnot. So I had to get the smog pump out of the way to get the engine mount bolt out. But yeah, 99,000 miles on this thing. I'm guessing it's original. It's not real greasy. Look at the valve cover gaskets ain't leaking. The oil pan ain't all greasy. The tranny wasn't all greasy. She's a pretty clean unit. I'm guessing, being a 15 passenger, a lot of like carpenters and plumbers and carpet laying guys. Carpet layers, not carpet munchers. They like these vans. So, but all, since all the seats were in it, I can't, I think it was just a, like a school had it, or a church, or a municipality, or whatever. It was a people hauler. So I think it was pretty well taken care of. I mean, it did have a hitch on it, so maybe it towed a little bit, but we saved the drive shaft. That exhaust is actually all good shape, and it's all original. It's got this surrounding on it, rear heat and rear air on that thing. Like the tranny cross member ain't all grimy. Look at that. I think it's a 375, is that what they call these things, where they got the bolt on rear yoke? But I think we can just take that bolt out, put a regular yoke on it if you need a slider yoke. But yeah, that thing ain't all greasy grimy gopher guts.
Greasy grimy gopher guts.
So yeah, good deal. Vans, the gift that keep on a giving.
Welcome back to another Mortske Minute, brought to you by none other than mortske.com. Go check them out for all your merch things, like sweatshirts, ball caps, t-shirts, magnetic koozies, magnetic screwdrivers, church keys, banners, scrapers, super scrapers. We got them too. Anyway, today's Mortske Minute is about the turbo hydromatic transmission, as shown in what I'm probably sitting in right now, and also the van that we're discussing this week. So this is a turbo hydromatic 400 transmission in said van, which started out as the hydromatic, well, not the turbo 400, but anyway, GM in the 30s wanted a fully automatic transmission. So they started developing it in the 30s, and in 1939, it was available as the hydromatic for Cadillac and Oldsmobile. It sounds like they only put them in Oldsmobiles and then in Cadillacs in 1940, because they wanted to put it in the Oldsmobiles because they were selling more Oldsmobiles than Buicks and Cadillacs. And if it was a failure, it just gave Oldsmobile a black eye and not their top tier Buick and Cadillacs. So that's how they kind of dipped it out there. It was a $57 option back in 1939, which is equivalent to a little over $1,000 in today's monies, or yesterday's monies, and it's probably like $1,400 now. But anyway, in 1941, it bumped up to a $100 option, big money. And of course, Cadillac doing Cadillac things, it was $125 in a Cadillac. When it was released in 1939 in the Oldsmobile, it was listed as the first mass-produced fully automatic transmission for passenger car use. Somebody's going to argue with me. This is what the internet says, but it was the first widely, readily, mass-produced, available automatic transmissions for passenger car use. It was also advertised as the greatest advance since the self-starter. If you don't know what a self-starter is, you used to have to crank them yourself. And then you got electric starters, as we know them today. My favorite thing to work on, the self-starter. So as we all know, 1942 came around, the war broke out, manufacturers stopped producing cars. But by this point, GM had produced over 200,000 of the hydromatic transmissions. And guess what happened come the war? They used them some more. They used them behind Cadillac V8s in dual Cadillac V8s, nonetheless, in Stuart tanks. And by the time the war came out, they used all the information that they gained from the time spent in these machines and the hours put on them and the operators, and they advertised them as battle-tested. Yeah. I mean, it's not lying. I mean, it's better than military-grade aluminum beer cans on the side of your new pickup that you're making payments on. But anyway, that's another thing.
I'm surprised that they're trying to put a product out like this, you know, and they're supposed to sell Ford Tough.
So, after the war got over, WW2, Pontiac was added to the list in 1948 as having the availability of the hydromatic transmission as well. You'll notice talking about the hydromatic, we have yet to mention Chevrolet and Buick. That's right, these guys didn't use the hydromatic right off the bat. They developed their own automatic transmissions. Chevrolet followed suit with the Power Glide that everybody knows about, and Buick the Dynaflow, which I think most people know about as well. Different versions of the hydromatic, or their own versions of the automatic, if you will. Neat thing is the Oldsmobile equipped car has got the Futuramic emblem on the front fender behind the wheel. And by 1949, General Motors had sold 1 million hydromatic transmissions. They were so popular, in fact, that Hudson, Nash, Rambler, Kaiser, Fraser, Willys, even Lincoln, Austin, Rolls-Royce, and Bentley all used their own proprietary versions of the hydromatic at one point. So these things were so good that everybody else wanted them as well, including Lincoln, the top tier of Ford's car entourage, if you will. And then disaster struck on August 12, 1953. The Livonia, Michigan plant burned to the ground. Was this the end of the hydromatic? No, absolutely not. But it put a little hiccup in things. So not only was GM using the hydromatic in a large majority of their fleet, but so were these other motor companies. So as you can imagine, GM took care of themselves first and scrambled, and the Pontiacs were getting Power Glides in them and so on and so forth. They were using some Borg Warners, but the other guys, they kind of moved on and got their own transmissions from other suppliers as well. Now to what we're talking about here, the Turbo Hydromatic, which was the replacement for the Hydromatic, the Turbo 400, or the Turbo Hydromatic 400, the TH-400, was first released in the 1964 Cadillacs. Buick also had a version called the Super Turbine 400. And by 1973, all GM used the Turbo Hydromatic 400s, or the Turbo Hydromatic. Here's a couple of small side notes. The TH-375, which is basically a Turbo 400 with a Turbo 350 output shaft. Some HD or heavy duty 350s used a 400 output shaft, and these were called the THM-375-B. And then also there's the 3L80HD, or also known as the TH-475, which had a straight cut planetary gear set. There's no way to tell these apart apparently from the outside, but on the inside they got the straight cut planetary gears. They're heavier gear set. I don't know much about them. Probably shouldn't be talking about them, but anyway. And then there's the THM-425. Yeah, you guessed it. This is a front-wheel drive 400. So I'm guessing these would come in like the big Cadillacs, the Eldorados that were front-wheel drive, the Olds Tornados, and such. But I'm just taking a guess. I didn't dig into this a whole lot. This is Mortske Minutes. We only got a minute to prepare for this stuff. So much like the Hydromatic, the Turbo Hydromatic was very popular with other suppliers, such as, you guessed it, Checker, Humvee, which is a division of AM General, I guess, Nissan, Rolls-Royce, Ferrari? I can't prove it because I've probably never even seen a Ferrari. Jeep, of course, just everybody else's parts, and AMC, which was probably part of Jeep at that time, or Jeep was part of AMC, I guess. So, there you go. The Turbo Hydromatic 400 and its ancestry. And we're not even opening up into the 700 R4. Fun fact, it was pretty much dissolved in 1991 and replaced with the 4L80E, which was an overdrive, is an overdrive, because of economy, everything else involved with that. But it was still used in Humvees and other applications past 1991. So like I said, we're not going to talk about the TH400, the TH200, the 700R4, the 204R, and probably a bunch of other ones that I'm forgetting about. And then you got the Power Glides and the Dynaflows and all that. But there's a tidbit of history on General Motors' patented Hydromatic name and the history behind it. Now back to your regularly scheduled shenanigans. Get back to work.
All right. I'm going to drain the coolant out of that block so that we stop leaving a trail on the floor. Speaking of that, I'm pretty proud of myself. I didn't make that big of a mess. That's pretty good for me. Throw the hood back on it and clean the inside out, take the seats out, and then fill it full of small blockheads, blocks, trannies. I don't know. We'll use it for storage for something. But we got to put some tin over the windows. That's to be determined later. All right. I'm gonna go take a lunch break. Yeah, got her done this morning, 11:30. We probably didn't start on this till 9 o'clock, 2.5 hours. The old tranny jack and the air powered lift and the two post lift was a real savior on this project. Oh, and the other thing you gotta do is you gotta hook the chain real short. I had to take my swivel hook out of there, hook the chain up as close as we can to the tranny. Tranny, to the carb plate, to the engine, whatever. All right, let's strip this thing down, everything we don't need. And we'll be ready for a good pressure washing. And of course, she's plugged up in there. We're gonna use our screwed by Mortske repair screwdriver to knock the sludge out, and then the coolant will come, I bet. There it is. Sweet, this thing is ready to go pressure washing, I think. We got some nice accessory brackets and pulleys to throw in our stash. We got some nice factory headers to, there we go, we can put a blower on it. I could put those back on it and nobody can give me grief for not running headers. What brand is that? The old W5, the Wards? Webb, never heard of the Webb. Well, yeah, obviously this intake and distributor is going to get swapped out when we put that one on there, but we'll leave it on there to try to keep as much water from pressure washing out of the engine as we can. Same deal with the fuel pump. Won't be running that, but we don't want that leads to the oil pan. Try to keep as much water out of there as we can, but we'll pressure wash it and then hopefully we'll run it shortly thereafter, or at least we'll drain the oil and get the water out of it because she needs an oil change. It's got some Delco R44T's in it. Yeah, I don't think this thing's ever been opened up. So you can tell from the factory, GM uses silicone in there. There's no gasket on the China walls. See? Silicone. Don't use the China wall gaskets. But it did have, you know, this is different than
The headers actually had gaskets in them. I'm almost positive with stock manifolds. They just planed them, steel on steel, no gaskets. I try not to use gaskets, unless you really need them. Freshly planed surface, seals up great. All right, Ondro says it's noontime, take a break. Maybe we'll pressure wash this when we get back. Maybe we'll throw this together and get it out of here. Who knows what we'll do? I'll think about it for a while, what our next move is gonna be. Look at you. Such a distinguished young gentleman.
Oh, Baxter, you are my little gentleman.
All right, the old gold dust here is headed for skid row. Or storage unit row, I don't know.
Took some rough measurements. Hopefully we can find a hood that's 21 by 26 or a door panel. And screw over the busted out windows. Put the hood on, put the valance, both of them. Yeah. We ain't gonna put the bumper back on because we might steal the, I think the grill guard, bumper guards, bumperettes, whatever. I think they're the same as a pickup, so that's worth more than the rest of the van. Anywho, we're gonna push her back by the pit, and I think we'll, we got a little high school kid comes out and helps us once in a while when he decides to come to work. Oh, that ain't that Dodge making all that noise. He can clean. Ooh, is that a sissy bar for a bike? Dang!
Dang.
Anyway, we'll get DB to throw all this in the pit, that everything that can be burned, and the rest can go in the trash. And then we'll be able to store motors and trannies and stuff in here.
Oh, crap.
I gotta put the doghouse on there. Sorry, forgot about you. We don't want critters coming in and out. So I'm gonna throw that on there, and then we'll push her out in the back. There's still a lot of good stuff here. I don't know what. Stole the gas pedal because it's got the Turbo 400 electronic kickdown. Like I said, there's an AM FM there. There's a tilt, but it's got the key switch in it and it's all wallered out. Yeah. But I mean, there's stuff. There's door handles. There's a good dash. You know, maybe you'll need some visors. These tall back buckets, I think, are the same as the pickups, and they're not terrible. They're brown, terrible color, but we're gonna take them out of here because that's more room to store junk. All right, enough rambling. Back to skid row. All
right, let's get this. I've been doing some pressure washing already, so we might as well sneak this van engine in there too. Let's get this thing all cleaned up. Maybe we'll even paint it up. Just kidding, probably not. It's 30 degrees, and we got a pretty decent west wind, and my fingers are already frozen, so let's hurry up and get this pressure washing over with. There will be no dancing.
Are you gonna come help?
Yeah, I doubt it. This requires thumbs.
Is it all dried off, Duff? We got our floor dry, cleaned up. Get all our parts stashed away. Now all we got left is a one piece rear main seal with perimeter bolt heads in the old style quadrajet intake and HEI. This is kind of neat. And then with those factory headers, this is a pretty good combination, I think, as far as for cast iron pieces. Okay. The block's really the only part's any good because the one piece rear main. But
so what I think we're gonna do is we're just gonna pop this intake off and the valve covers. We'll throw some different mystery valve covers on it that I got out of my stash. And we're just gonna bolt that blower on there. Old slick 50 says we gotta pin the crank, which makes sense. We'll show that in another video, but basically you drill through the crank in the end, you put a quarter inch dowel pin in there or a roll pin so that that way it doesn't shear as easily as the keyway that's on there. Cause I guess those keys will shear and then it'll spin on the crank. And then you got a mess, so makes sense. Kit's pretty reasonable. Never done one before, so we're learning. But no camshaft, no lifters, no heads, no nothing. Comment down below if you want to see that, and if there's something that I'm absolutely missing, like pinning the crank. But yeah, just blower on a budget. We'll stick a short water pump on it and the brackets off of that other engine, and we'll have ourselves a budget 5.7 blown motor. Bad news is, I was cleaning out the van because I couldn't wait for DB to show up because he apparently didn't want to come to work this week. But look at the stuff we found.
2 quarts of oil, and plus we saw that oil leak in there, which that engine is really dry, so I don't know what's going on there, but maybe she's an oil burner. And look at these. Not only did we get a slightly used Phillips 66 bucket, I got a stack of these things. Acorn, plastic, chrome, simulated nuts. Guess what? If you are one of the first, I don't know, 35 people to order a Mortske repair church key. Yeah, remember these things? Some kids probably never seen one before, but get your Mortske church key. And for the first however many that we sell, we're going to send you one of these guys. Put a note on there if you want me to sign it. I'll sign it for you. Brand new tarp straps. Those were in the van. Guess what? Anybody? Not anybody. One lucky person buys a cap, put in the notes that you want a Coleman cooler. We'll throw your cap inside there. It's pretty clean. And we'll ship that out to you. Anybody or the couple lucky people who, look at this, the Truckee Tahoe Inn. When ice gives you grief, the inn offers you relief.
So these are ice scrapers for scraping off your windshield. That's a 3/8 ratchet. The motor's running back there. But anyway, we got SS5s and SS5 shorts in stock right now. And if you order one of those gas scrapers, you might get lucky, get yourself a windshield scraper in there.
And then we get these license plates. I always end up with a pile of license plates. Somebody orders a t-shirt, comment that you want a license plate, we'll send that out to you. Hang her up on your wall. Skippy got all the carpet out. I got all the seats out.
Tech tip of the day, seat foam is quite flammable. And it leaves a lot of black smoke like you're burning tires. So I heard.
Said he couldn't get the seat bases out. Said something about there's a head that turns. Oh, the bolt just comes out the bottom side. You just check this thing out, Duff. Ooh, is that a penny? It's a nickel. Get it. Get it. Get it. Oh, what year? Be a 68. 1993. Oh, I found an Arizona license plate in here too. But yeah, this thing will look good full of junk, eh, Duff? Once we get some windows sealed up. But yeah, I'm guessing we're gonna have to go underneath and get a socket and get these out of there. You know, so we got more room for activities. So much room for activities.
Look at all this floor space. So much aerobics in here. So many activities.
Got the heater out of the corner. Oh yeah, good to go.
So yeah, go check out the merch, mortski.com. We got banners, we got ball caps, we got the greasy cap competition coming up May 5th. We're gonna give away some pretty good prizes for that. So get your cap if you ain't got one. And you might need a, you might win a cooler for keeping your sandwiches cold when it gets warm out. Speaking of warm out, grab a hoodie before it gets warm out. We got shirts, we got pens, we got magnetic screwdrivers. We only got the flower ones on hand. We're waiting on the Screwed by Mortske Repair ones. You guys bought us all out, but yeah, we got decals, you name it, we got it. And now we got the church keys. I set mine down, but if you're a bottle drinker, or you open paint cans, or you got some old style oil cans, you need a church key, or it makes a good keychain. These things are pretty sweet, so get yourself one. But anyway, that's what we're gonna do. We got ourselves a 86 Chevy van running, stole the engine out of it, stole the Turbo 400 out of it, got some good trinkets out of it. Comment down below if you want to see us huck a blower on that engine and then put it in a, build a 55 Chevy gasser, throw it in a 56 with a 4-speed, maybe throw it in a Nova with no drivetrain in it. What else we got? We got the Bluzer, the 2-wheel drive Blazer, we can throw it in that thing. We got so many options.
Maybe we get the junk flathead out of that 36 Ford pickup. Put in a Model 8 coupe, huh? I'm gonna be better than putting, never mind that stuff over there. Or that.
All right. Oh yeah, we got fender covers too. Mortske.com. All right. Thank you very much for watching. Check out our other videos. Remember, it doesn't matter how you get it done, as long as you're having fun. On to the next one.
What'd you do? Just playing with your nuts over here?
Just playing with my nuts.
This is what your hobbies are, is including spilling nuts all over and picking them up? You should find a new hobby. I'm gonna dump a couple more out for you.
Sure.